What's up, investors? My name is Artem Dikirf, and in a couple of minutes, you'll know what is additional paid-in capital. I'll first give you a professional definition, and then I'll explain it as easy as I can with examples. And if you want to learn personal finances and investing by watching such short videos, please consider subscribing to my channel and liking this video to show the support for the young creator. Many more videos are coming. Thank you so much, and let's get straight to the point. Alright, so additional paid-in capital is an accounting term for excessive amount that investors pay above the face value of a stock. Additional paid-in capital is recorded under shareholders' equity section on a balance sheet. And if you're not sure what shareholders' equity or a balance sheet means, feel free to watch my previous videos. And here is an example. Additional paid-in capital can only be recorded during a company's IPO. Let's assume a company issues its shares for the first time and sets the price to be at $50 per share. During an IPO, some shares of a company were purchased directly from this company at $60 per share. $50 will be recorded under common stock account on a balance sheet. And this excessive $10 amount will go under additional paid-in capital. And the reason why additional paid-in capital is taken into consideration only during an IPO is the following. Think about buying a car. A dealership purchased this car for $30,000 from the manufacturer. And then the dealership attempts to sell this car to a customer for $38,000. This additional $8,000 is the profit that the dealership wants to keep. As soon as the car is sold, the first owner drives it for a couple of years. Decades later, this car became an extremely rare model, therefore its price increased. So the first owner decided to sell it above its purchase price. The new price tag is $70,000. And when our first owner is able to find the buyer and sell this car, he's the only one that gets to keep this money. The dealership and the car manufacturer gets nothing from this transaction. They got their money at the time of initial sale and that's it. Same idea with the stocks. A company receives money directly from its investors only during an IPO. All the other trades that are made with these shares are not affecting the amount of capital that was initially raised. If a company raised $50 million during an IPO when its share prices were $50 per share, this capital will not turn into $70 million when the share price becomes $70 per share 1 year later. So, like mentioned previously, if the price during an IPO was set to be at $50 per share, every single dollar that investors pay above this $50 goes towards additional paid-in capital. All the transactions that happen after an IPO that will affect the share price will not count towards additional paid-in capital. Because these transactions happen on the secondary market between investors, not between an issuing company and investors anymore. And if you still have any questions after watching this video, feel free to leave a comment and I'll personally reply to you. Check my other videos to see if there is anything else you want to learn about personal finances and investing. Thank you all so much for spending this couple of minutes with me. I really hope there was something new that you learned today. It was straight to the point.